All right, this is my wonderful keyboard player for many years, John Arbour. They said we should tell a little bit of the story of the blues or our relationship to the blues. So I'll just start out by saying I was born and raised in Greenwich Village many years ago. We're not going to do the math. And I ran away from home. I was just had barely turned 17. But since I lived in Greenwich Village, which is the epicenter of all things hip, I only had to run about 6 blocks away. I didn't really want to leave the neighborhood. And I got a job. I still was in high school. And I got a job so I could, you know, support myself taking care of these 2 little kids for this family. And I know God sent me to that house because the couple every night went out, almost every night, and after I put the kids to sleep, I would explore. They had walls of records. They had every imaginable kind of record from floor to ceiling, and they had, all of Louis Armstrong, all of Duke Ellington, all of great American music these people had in there on the record shelf. And so every night I'd pick up different stuff, all kinds of stuff. And then one night, I can remember it like it was yesterday, I came across the entire collection of Bessie Smith on the original CD.
Woo! Yeah! All right!
I didn't know. I never heard of her, but I started looking through and saw... Could you kind of hold off from the flash? Because I have a very short attention span and I totally forget what I'm saying. Thank you. You can take some later on. Anyway, I opened them up and there it was. Empty Bed Blues, parts 1 and 2.
Wow.
I said, that sounds like an interesting subject. And I'll never forget putting the record on, putting the needle down, hearing that scratchy little 78 go around. And then all of a sudden, out of the speakers came the most soulful, profoundly, deeply amazing voice I had ever heard in my entire young life. And right in that moment, I was transfixed. I guess they call that an epiphany or something. I just never heard anything like that in my life. The depth of expression and soul that this woman was pouring out through her voice. And right then and there I said, I want to do that when I grow up.
All right.
And you know, it's been a long journey, but I got to do it. And so that was the first blues I ever heard. Although I did listen to early R&B on the radio, and I had been hearing like Little Walter and Muddy Waters, but the first early blues I had ever heard. And I quickly learned that song and several others, some Ma Rainey tunes, and Greenwich Village, in case you don't know, was the epicenter of what we now call the folk scare of the early 60s. And people were, in the urban north, were busy rediscovering all the wonderful American roots music, most of which came out of the rural south, so people were getting turned on to Appalachian old-timey music and blues, Delta blues, and this kind of blues, and bluegrass, all kinds of stuff. So there were lots of jams. They called them hootenannies back in the day. And so I would sing these songs, and people responded well, so that encouraged me. So here I am, 47 years later, here in Kitchener, Ontario. So anyway, I thought I'd start out by singing the first blues tune, real blues tune I ever heard, and then I'll talk a little bit more about the women in the blues and just how important they are, not only musically, but just I think they're some of our most important cultural elders, and I'll explain why. But they didn't mince any words, they just sang it like it is. So here, without further ado, if I can remember the words, Empty Bed Blues. Make me feel awful mean and blue. When the bed gets empty, make me feel awful mean and blue. Well, my springs are getting rusty, sleeping single like I do. With an awful ache in here, I woke up this morning with an awful ache in here. Oh, my new man had left me just a room in an empty bed. Got the best one I could find. Well, I bought him a mattress. Got the best one I could find. Well, I bought him some coffee, 'cause he had a brand new grind. He come home one evening with his spirits way up high.
Could you not get off, please?
He come home one evening with his spirits way up high. Lord, what he had to give me made me wring my hands and cry. I never had before. Oh, he taught me a lesson I never had before. Lord, what he had to give me made me wring my hands till I was sore. Dive with a stroke that can't go wrong. He's a deep sea diver with a stroke that can't go wrong. And he can touch the bottom, 'cause his window's out so. He made it nice and hot. Lord, he bought my first cabin. He made it nice and hot. Lord, when he put in the bacon, it overflowed the pot. Lord, he had such good, good loving that I couldn't help myself. I ran out there and told my girlfriend Lou. I don't know what I was thinking, 'cause by the way she's raving, she must have gone and tried some too. Girls, when you get good loving, never go and spread the news.